Okay, right, we're in a particularly loud TT track car. It's a GTX 3076, Ignitron ECU, 1080X injectors, 1900 engine, I think. I'm just going to go through, see where the lambda adaptions are at the minute, apply some learned values, go back to some cells that are still learning. So we'll run that in the dyno in steady state mode. Should be here. So we'll go set an RPM. In here, find myself what the gear ratio is. 39.7. Really handy if this software remembered that. Note to VTEC. Okay, let's get it rolling. And we're off. Second gear. Third gear. Okay, let's get back into the Ignitron. Minimize this a little bit so I can drag the screen down. Now, what I find handy quite often is to break yourself some little gauges, so these gauges stay on screen all the time, so you can flick between screens and not have to keep searching for some parameters you want to look at. One of which for field trimming is look at short term, so you can see exactly what's being moved. Shrink it down a bit. Park it over here. Look at another gauge. Want to see some RPM. So, sensors RPM. Shrink it down a bit. So I'm looking at doing V table adjustments. Well, I need to see what the pressures are. So, sensors, map sensor. So we've got RPM, we've got map sensor, so we can tell exactly where we are in a particular table, VE or learned lambda. And because I don't ultimately trust this car, it's not one of our builds. Keep an eye on engine coolant temperature, just in case. Yeah, it's at 97. Consider it not actually doing anything again. That is warm. To keep an eye on them. Okay, so put the brake on. The brakes are on. Let's drop some RPM down. Let's turn the steps down to 50. Go down a bit, down a bit, down a bit. Set it to a flat RPM. Okay, so brakes are on and functioning slowly. So what I want you to do, just going to see what's going on. It's really low RPM, 1250, 15. So we're set at 1750 at the minute, so I'll just drop it down to 15. So in this column currently, nearly, there we are. So still some values to learn at 50 kPa. I'm at 100 kPa in a minute. So just rolling off the throttle. See if I can maintain 10 RPM. Not really, I've dropped into the 1200. Never mind. Just learning some of that. As you can see here, rolling off the throttle a bit more, rolling back on the throttle. All I'm doing now is just gently rolling on and off the throttle. So this speed and this RPM, you literally are just cruising around. This is all part throttle, driving around town stuff typically. It's the least easy to do on a dyno. Nonetheless, it can be done. I'm going to bump the RPM just a bit above 1500. So I could go above and just roll back, get to the 50 kPa. This does have a big throttle body on it. So, yeah. Not so easy to get to 50 kPa. You see, up at 86, I'm barely touching the throttle. Right, won't get too bogged down in that. And one of the other things that we were doing on this is auxiliary output. Is what's doing our water math. So I've got it set to turn on at 4000, turn off at 2, and the boost has to be above 250 kPa. I'll play with those settings in a minute. We've not actually run it yet. So what I'll do, drop the screen down. So what we should see happen, I'll enable it, save the file. That's inactive at the minute because we're below 4000, we haven't got any boost. Just start recording data log, see what's going on. I've just got foot to the floor, it's rolling, accelerating slowly. You can see briefly we went over 1.5 bar boost. We're just going to drop that down a bit, make it 1.2 bar. This is the first time it's been run. Let's have a look if we can see any intake temps drop when the meth's on. Inlet air temp, there she is. So I'll keep it on screen. Yeah, so just roll it up again. On the throttle on boost. Okay. see that it's turning on and off by myself, what boost is doing what preset we're actually in. Look at preset selector. Where are we? Okay, I'm currently in 4, which is the higher boost one. Press the mappy button. One lowest one, two, up 3. Boost control. Preset 4. 3 even, 0.4, okay, so we should see it come on relatively low. Let's go back into the user defines. Watch it come in, hopefully. I'm going to change the break into RPM. Set it up. A bit too much. 4,000. Okay, that's just 4,000 RPM at this shift point, which is fifth gear. So I'll roll on and off the throttle. Let's get close to it first. I didn't know any better, I would say this water bath isn't spraying at all. Way too hot. Okay, save the log. DYNO 60 WMI test. Okay. Go check it out, see what's occurring.